In this video, I'll show you how to build this countdown timer with the help of website if you are selling different products or courses, and if you are giving different discount offers or you are launching brand new products or courses, then this might be the better way to inform your clients that just go there and save some money or pre-order, you know, something like that. So if you want to add this kind of feature, then countdown timer is the one that you are looking for. Without further ado, let's start. Hello and namaste everyone, this is Jitsaru with Coding Design. Welcome to our channel. If you are new here, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. Now let's change the title. For the title, I am giving countdown timer feature coming soon page with HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Now with the help of Live Server extension, let's open this index.html file in our default browser. As you can see, this is the result. This video is part of series, so this video's playlist will be given in the description below or in your top right corner. You can check out that I button. As you can see, we have already built that smart navigation bar with page scroll progress bar. Now in our index.html file, within that div with class name landing, let's create another div with class name countdown. And inside that, I am creating h2 heading. And also next to that, let's create paragraph tag. Similarly, let's create button. As you can see, I have already linked the style.css file. So in our style.css file, let's style that div with class name countdown. So for the class countdown, I'm giving position of absolute. As you know, it is the child of that div with class name loading. So for that, I'm giving position of relative. Now let's take that div with class name countdown to right side. So for the right, I am giving 5vw. But when I was editing this video, at the time I have noticed that as a designer's perspective, countdown timer's position that you have placed, that is not right, okay? It would be better if you place this countdown to the center. Similarly, for the top, I am giving 18vh. And also let's give the width. For the width, I am giving 24 rem. For the text color, I am giving white color. And also let's keep text align to center. Similarly, I'm giving display flex. Let's give flex direction to column. For the row gap, I'm giving 1 rem. And also when you hover that div with class name countdown, I'm giving transform scale to 1.06. But in your browser, when you take your mouse near to that countdown, there isn't any smooth transition. So for that, for the div with class name countdown, let's give the transition. For the transition duration, I'm giving 0.4 second. And for the timing function, let's give is in out. Similarly, now let's style the button element that is within our div with class name countdown. So for that button, I'm giving align self. Let's give it to center. And also I'm giving background color of orange red color. Let's remove that border. For that, I'm giving border none. Similarly, let's give text color to white. For the padding top and bottom, I'm giving 1 rem. For the left and right, I'm giving 2 rem. Similarly, let's give the border radius of 0.6 rem. And also cursor to pointer. Now next to that paragraph tag, let's create div with class name date, and inside that I am creating another div with class name day. Within that, let's create h1 heading with class name day number. Similarly, next to that, let's create a small tag. Now let's select this code and let's duplicate it. We are giving the same thing for our hours, minutes and seconds. I'm just changing its values, okay? In your browser, you can see number of days, hours, minutes and seconds. So now let's style div with class name date. So for the div with class name date that is within our div with class name countdown, let's give display flex. Justify content to space evenly. For the align items, let's give center. Now let's give background color. For the background color, I am giving this white color with some transparent value. Similarly, for the padding top and bottom, I am giving 2 rem. For the left and right, 1 rem. And let's give some rounded corners. So for that, I am giving border radius of 0.6 rem. Similarly, I'm giving backdrop filter, I'm giving blur value to 2 pixel. Now in your browser, you can see backside of your countdown, we're getting that blurry image. Similarly, let's give text shadow. For the X offset, I'm giving 0. For Y offset and spread value, I'm giving 0.1 rem. For the color, let's give this black color with some transparent value. Normally, I like to avoid text shadow, but in this case, I think it's better to give that text shadow. Now, let's take our browser to the full screen by pressing F11 key. I think for that countdown, I have to change that top value. Let's change it to 15 VH. I think between our days, hours, minutes, and seconds, if I give colon, now it is looking better. But the values that we are giving, that is all static value. So let's make it dynamic, okay? So with the help of JavaScript code, we are going to change all these values dynamically. So as you can see, I have already linked the script.js file. So now in our script.js file, I'm creating variable name future. Let's assign date object. So I'm writing new date. So within that date, you can pass the future date. You can call it expiry date. So I'm giving month, day, year, as well as hour, minute, and seconds. And along with that, if I write dot get time, so now with the help of this method, I'll be able to get number of milliseconds from the expiry date that we have given, okay? And also now we need to get the current date that you are running on. So for that, again, I am creating another variable present and I'm assigning new date. And along with that, if I write dot get time, once again, with the help of this method, we are trying to get number of milliseconds that we are currently running on. Now, next step is to get the difference between our future and the present time. For that, once again, let's create another variable time period and I'm assigning future minus present. Now next step is to calculate the days, hours, minutes, and seconds from that time period. So first of all, I'm creating constant variable second, that 1 second represents 1000 milliseconds. So as you know, 1 second, that is equal to 1000 milliseconds. And also let's create minute variable. Now in order to get that 1 minute, now if I multiply that second by 60, that will give me 1 minute. Similarly, you can calculate hour. And for days, as you know, 24 hours, that makes 1 day. So I'm giving there 24. Now within these variables, we are storing unit value that represents milliseconds. So now in order to get that days, hours, minutes, and second from our time period, let's create another variable D that represents day and I'm assigning time period. Divide by day. So now with the help of this code, I'll be able to get the number of days from that time period, but you will get the result with long decimal digit. So in order to prevent that, you can wrap all this code with small bracket. And now I'm using math object. Now with the help of that math.floor, you'll be able to remove all the decimal digits from our result. Similarly, now we need to calculate the hours. So for that, again, I'm assigning same thing, math.floor. But now be careful, I'm not dividing, I'm using their percentage. Now with the help of that modulus operator, I'm trying to get the remainder from our time period. So if I give their day, now you will be able to get the number of days, but we want the number of hours, okay? So for that, let's wrap all this code with our small bracket and let's divide by hour. But be careful, that hour is the single unit on that we have calculated just above, you can see. Now let's duplicate the same code for more 2 times. And now logic is similar, instead of that day, you can change it to hours, and now we need to convert that hours into minutes, so you have to divide by minute. Similarly for the second, now we need to change it into minutes, and in order to convert that minute into second, I'm dividing by second. Finally, we have calculated number of days, hours, minutes, and second from our time period. So now it's time to display all those numbers in our browser. As you can see in our index.html file, for h1 heading, I have given their different class name, something like for the days, I have given their class name day number. For the hours, I have given their hour number and so on. Okay, so now we can select all these h1 headings with different class name. For that, I'm writing document.query selector. So we are selecting h1 heading with class name day number. If I write dot inner text, you can give their d that represents day. Now let's duplicate it for more 3 times. Now let's change that day number into hour number, and instead of that d, let's give h. I did use their comma so that I don't need to write that let keyword multiple times. But at the end, now you need to remove that comma. Instead, let's keep semicolon for the minutes and seconds. Simultaneously, I'm changing all those value. once more in your browser. Look at that, we're getting all the number of days, hours, minutes and seconds. Actually you can call it like expiry date, but I want to create a countdown. It's something like now in every second we need to update that value. So for that, first of all, let's create the function name update countdown. Now let's take all this code within that function, and now we have to invoke or call that update countdown function. So as I have already told you that we need to update that countdown in every second. So for that you can use set interval or set timeout function. I'm using set timeout function. So now within that set timeout function, for the first parameter you can give the timer handler. So for that you can give their update countdown function, and for the second parameter it will take the timeout. Time that we want is the 1 second, so I need to pass the 1000 because it will take in milliseconds. So now with the help of this code we will call our update countdown function after each 1 second. Now in your browser, did you see that in every seconds our countdown is updating? But you can see when you reach to the single digit, at that time I want to give there extra zero in front of that digit. Okay, so for that you can write something like d is equal to, so now if our days value, if that is less than 10, so I'm using ternary operator, so if that is the case then let's keep their string, I'm giving 0, and let's join that with our days. If our days value that is greater than 10, in that case we'll give the same days value. Okay, so once again let's duplicate it for more 3 times. We'll give the same thing for our hours, minutes and seconds. Now just you need to change all those variables. Okay, it's that simple. Once more in your browser, did you see that when you reach to that single digit we are giving that extra zero in front of that digit? Okay, if you don't want this, you don't need to write that code. So what if your future date that you have given, if that is expired? So for that let's change expiry date. Okay, in your browser did you see that we are getting there 0 minus 1? It's because as you can see just a moment ago we have given there one condition. So that condition was when your days value or the hours value, if those value were less than 10, then at that time we were joining our string 0 just before that single digit. Now we need to display message something like our date is expired or something like that, you know. Also for that you can give their condition something like I'm writing if our time period that is less than 0. So instead of these dates, minutes and seconds, you know, we will change it into some text. So for that you can write something like document.querySelector. So we are selecting the div with class name date, and be careful, I'm giving their dot inner html. So we will replace all those different date, hours, minutes and second into message. Within a string I'm giving their h1 heading, and for that message I'm giving their expired with that crying emoji. In your browser did you see that we are getting their expired? So if our time period, if that is expired, then we are displaying their message expired. As you can see we have used their set timeout function. After each 1 second we are calling our function name update countdown. So if your time period is expired, there is no point in executing that code. Okay, instead we need to delete that timer. So for that, first of all let's store that set timeout function in timer variable, and now within that condition you can write something like clear timeout. Now with the help of this function you will be able to delete that timer that you have given just above there. Now if you play with these future dates, now you will be able to get different number of time, and if your date is expired you will get message expired. So now you can see it is working perfectly, but I have noticed there, like when you scroll down we are not getting that page scroll progress bar. So why is that? You can see for the header I have given their position of sticky, and also for that David class name landing I have used their position as well. Okay, now you can bring that header element just all of above. Now you can give their gindex of 100 or you can give 1000. It's just that you have to give higher value than other elements because we want that navigation bar or the header all of above. Once again in your browser if you scroll we are getting that page scroll progress bar, and also our countdown timer that is working perfectly, and I think everything is working fine. But as I have already told you that as a designer's perspective, countdown timer's position that you have placed, that is not right. Okay, you can change that, you can bring it to the center. So that's all for today. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you did learn something, smash that like button. If you have any kind of queries, let me know in the comment box. Share this video if you think someone needs it, and also if you haven't already yet, hit that subscribe button and also the notification bell icon. Remember, there is always more to learn, so keep learning.